Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So this chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, it is a progressive lung disease in which the narrowing of airways will occur and it will lead to airflow obstruction. So the patient cannot take the air freely. He cannot inhale and he cannot exhale the air freely. So what is the pathophysiology of this chronic obstructive pulmonary disease? The pathophysiology involves when the patient inhales irritants, if any irritants are inhaled into the human body, these irritants which will cause the inflammatory cells to accumulate. The inflammatory cells will be accumulated and these inflammatory cells, they will release some inflammatory mediators. The mediators, examples of these mediators are TNF alpha factor and interleukins. These are the inflammatory mediators. Because of this inflammatory mediators, these causes inflammation at the site. This inflammation will lead to tissue damage. Because of that, there will be some structural changes in the lungs which leads to this chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Then when it comes to types of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, there are mainly two types of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. First one is chronic bronchitis. So chronic bronchitis means it is the production of cough at least 3 months during 2 successive years. See, within 2 years, the patient will get this cough for 3 months. So that type of chronic obstructive disease is known as chronic bronchitis. And the next one is emphysema. Emphysema is the enlargement of air spaces in the lungs. So the enlargement of air spaces in the lungs is done because of the damage of alveolar walls which are present in the lungs. So this disease is known as emphysema. So according to these diseases, this chronic obstructive pulmonary disease is classified into 5 stages in the patients. Stage 1, that is stage 0, that is the patient will be at risk. And stage 1 means he will be at a mild risk. Stage 2 means moderate risk. Stage 3 means the patient is at severe risk. And stage 4 means the patient will be in very severe risk, that is also known as chronic respiratory failure. Epidemiology includes, it is one of the leading death causing disease in the industrial nations because of the pollution. And etiology, the reason for this disease is mainly smoking. 15% of the smokers will get this chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. And the symptoms of the disease includes cough with or without sputum, and then dyspnea, that is nothing but shortness of breath. And the next one, diagnosis, the mainly that it is diagnosed with the patient history, and then spirometry. Spirometry is the device which is used for diagnosing this disease. It calculates the forced expiratory volume and forced vital capacity. What is forced expiratory volume? The amount of the air exhaled by the patient for 1 second. So the amount of air released by the patient for 1 second is calculated. It should be in the limits. And then forced vital capacity means the inhalations and exhalations of the patient. The inhaled air and exhaled air capacity of the patient will come under forced vital capacity. And the next one is arterial blood gas test will be there. It measures the amount of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the blood. In bronchitis disease, the oxygen levels will be low and carbon dioxide levels will be high. In emphysema disease, oxygen levels will be high and carbon dioxide levels will be in normal condition. And chest radiography is also performed for diagnosing this disease. The treatment of COPD involves mainly the smoking should be restricted by the patients, and for the patients, bronchodilators like albuterol, levetiracetam will be given, nebulizer will be provided, and corticosteroids like prednisolone, hydrocortisone, etc. of the corticosteroid drugs will be given to the patient, and oxygen therapy is given to the patient if the patient is having severe disease. And in the case of very severe disease, the lung transplantation is only the treatment for such type of patients. Thank you. Subscribe to my channel for more and more videos.